Since the days of middle and elementary school, I have a couple of models that I live by today, and these models have helped me through the tough times. Whenever I made a mistake in my life that I regret doing, I keep in mind that we'll make mistakes, live and learn. Whenever I feel that my life is really bad, I always keep in mind that it can only get better, and I always try to make it better. It took almost to the end of my fourth grade to make a real friend in my life, and when I had a friend, I was still bullied. When I was in elementary school, I hated to go to school, since I had no one that wanted to talk to me. When the kids wanted to talk to me, it was only so they could bully me so they could feel better about themselves. While all this was going on, my grades was at all-time low. Each time I got a report card for the grading period, there was always two U's on it. I never had an A the entire time in elementary school. When I finally met my first real friend, he introduced me with a bunch of other kids that also called me friend. The only problem that this was the neighborhood that just moved in, so I didn't really need friends at school. I thought I made a friend at school, so we ended up hanging out with each other the next weekend. But I found out that he just wouldn't use it with a giant rock. I ended up getting hit so hard with the rock that I had to get straight to the hospital since my head and a couple of stitches. He said it was an accident, and I believe it was something to get into trouble with the dog. When you're driving me insane, well then I think it's time that we took a break. I did make a friend that I did hang out with during and after school, and he was getting bullied at the same time I was in school. He first off was annoyed like everyone else thought, but he ended up finding out that he lived close to me and my friends. He also found out that he also went to the same church as me, so we started to become better friends. We have been friends since the sixth grade, and now we're about to graduate with the same friends that I knew since middle school. When I went into middle school, I wanted to play a sport, but I was too scared to, but my friends ended up signing me up for some sports, and the t-ball coach was on it as well. It was a cross country, and yes, I did ask that, do I have to run across the country, and ended up being the worst one on the team, and I really wanted to quit the team the first day of practice. You don't have to be a scientist to figure out that I didn't quit the team. Instead, I stuck with it, every day I got better. Ended up meeting more people every year, and by entering year, I've had a good amount of friends. Every day that I get up, I know that there's something going to happen with me and my friends. The reason I get up every day is for my team, my friends, and so I can achieve something great one day. I know that this might never happen, but my goal is just I start cross country and track and field to make the Olympics. I believe that when I go to college, I will have a good coach that will train me so hard and I'll be there one day. I had times when I really had bad grades. I had a repeated grade and I was already a year older than most kids. At times, go on, and the more that you work, the better that you become. I went from almost failing elementary school to averaging a 3.5 in high school. I also went from being one of the worst members of the cross country team to being the best member on the team today. My senior year of high school, I worked so hard every day to achieve my dreams as far as academically. When I go off to either of these colleges, I want to major in biology since I want to become a physical therapist. In my senior year in college, I want to reach the national level. I want to become the best runner cross country in the nation and the best 1600 meter runner in the nation as well.